So you may have heard of this new term, island architecture. But what is island architecture in the Jamstack world? When you ship your latest application using your favorite framework, whether that be React, Vue, or Svelte, each of those components contains JavaScript, even if it's a static file such as a nav link or just an image with some text. This is where island architecture comes in. Island architecture is a way to control the JavaScript that is shipped with your project and how that also interacts with your users. Let's look at a normal React application in the Jamstack world. Here is a diagram of a website. As you can see, there is a top section here with a bio, portfolio, podcast, and blog, and that would be our nav bar. Then we have this section here, which is our hero. And below the fold is a image section that is interactive. So it's like an image carousel, something like that. Currently, all of this is being shipped with JavaScript. So maybe this top section has 10 kilobytes, this section is 20 kilobytes, and our carousel is another 17. But this section here and this section here is completely static. The components aren't actually doing anything, they're not taking any state in, and they're not really worried about any JavaScript at all. So why are we shipping JavaScript? Below the fold, of course, is something that we do want JavaScript, but why is it loaded on the screen if the user isn't actually there? Now, this is how island architecture works. So if we look at this again and we're using island architecture, this top section has 0 kilobytes of JavaScript. So when it's sent out, there is 0 kilobytes. This section here has 0 kilobytes, and currently there is no JavaScript loaded on the page. When a user then scrolls in and this latest photo section is pushed onto the page, that JavaScript will then in turn load. So that's a brief explanation, but let's see it in practice. So there are many frameworks that you can do this with. We've got Astro, we've got Capri, and we've got Fresh, for example. So pick any of those, and this island architecture is on by default. I'm going to use Astro to show this off. So here we have two different components. We have a hero component and a button component. So the hero here doesn't have any client derivative, and this one has client visible. So let's look first at the hero. So this hero right here is just a div with some text and some images, just like the example that we saw, except from slightly different. So in theory, we don't need any client-side code here. We don't need any interactability. We don't need any of that. So for this one, we're not going to have any client code run. There should be no JavaScript involved, and we shouldn't see anything in the network when we load the page up. Now, with our second one, we have a button component here. Technically, this is not going to do anything, but we have a console log here and a button with an on-click handler just to make that fire. So inside of our index here, we have this client visible. So what this client visible does is say only load and hydrate this component when it becomes available in the viewport. So if you're at the top of the page and let's say it's under the fold, this won't load until that actually scroll far enough down for it to be in the viewport. There are other options like client load, which will happen when the page loads. We have client idle, which is when everything else is done. Go ahead and load it up and hydrate. There are lots of different options, but we're using client visible because we don't want it to load the JavaScript until it is on the page. So now we've kind of explained how this is set up. Let's look at the actual page. So here is the application. I've just modified my own website to show this off. And as you can see, there is no client-side code running currently. And we're going to see what happens as we scroll further down the page. So as we scroll, this network log should change. So scroll a bit, nothing has happened yet. So we scroll a bit further. And as you can see, this button component has been loaded and then it has been hydrated. And here's our little button in the left-hand corner. Now we can see this work a different way as well. I intentionally put that console log there for a reason, so you can see how it actually really works. So the console log will happen when the component is loaded and hydrated. So as we scroll, you can see loading dot 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 has now appeared on screen. So this goes to show that you don't need JavaScript to be loaded all the time to get those fancy websites, just when it's in the fold or when you really, really need it. So I hope you enjoyed this video on island architecture. If you did enjoy the video, make sure to drop it a like, comment on more things you want to see in the Jamstack, and of course, until next time, see ya!